As a 19-year-old student, I'm humbled to speak before this crowd today. This is an exciting time to be talking about energy. Our state has been invigorated by advances in renewable energy and efficiency in the last 10 years. My new favorite statistic? North Carolina has more installed solar capacity than the rest of the Southeast combined. Still, this is a drop in the electricity bucket. The Federal Energy Information Administration says that in North Carolina, fewer than 300 gigawatt hours of electricity come from renewables other than hydroelectric. Compare that with 4,900 gigawatt hours from coal or 3,100 gigawatt hours from nuclear. What is our state doing wrong? For the last 7 weeks, I've traveled to Spain, Germany, the Netherlands, and Denmark as part of a research seminar with fellow UNC Chapel Hill undergraduates. While traveling, we focused on the transition these countries are making to transform their economies, their cities, and their futures to include clean, renewable energy and smarter city planning. I left Europe impressed and angry. What can the US and North Carolina start doing better? Let's start with how we make arguments. As advocates of renewable energy and sustainable cities, we must lead with the most convincing arguments. In the US, this means talking about return on investment, jobs, and urban and rural revitalization first. I've seen firsthand how small German towns such as Wilpoldsried and Schonau have created self-sufficient economies with full employment because they were enriched by returns on renewable investment. Meanwhile, 1 in 5 rural Western North Carolinians live in poverty. While this issue is multifaceted, studies have shown that investment in renewables benefit rural communities more than others. So as important as the issues of climate change and energy independence are, I think we should focus our arguments on economics in a more effective way than we do now. That being said, North Carolina's utility structure severely limits the way that renewable projects could benefit the state's citizens. The current utility market structure exists in conflict with the idea of distributed energy resources. So we have to be okay with the American renewable energy transition seriously disrupting how utilities do business. Germany jumped from generating 6.6% of its electricity from renewables to 25.8% in only 13 years, while utilities still married to coal and nuclear, sound familiar? Faced a loss in market share. States should seriously reconsider how they deal with utilities that brashly continue their commitment to outdated forms of energy. North Carolina should follow California and Germany's lead and implement a feed-in tariff. This policy is one of many conditions that allowed so many Germans to install rooftop solar or buy a share in a wind turbine. There is a reason why, despite having a fraction of its land mass and solar insulation, Germany has considerably more installed solar capacity than in the U.S. But let's not stop at feed-in tariffs. By opening the door to power purchase agreements, North Carolina can inspire market-based competition, lower wholesale electricity prices, and recruit more job creators to move here. What I'm discussing not only takes forward-thinking policy, but political bravery. This bravery is something that American politicians have lacked since I entered the realm of political awareness. After this conference, enter a dialogue with local government leaders to see how they can create community investment through sustainable projects. When I visited the Basque Country, I met with an architect for public spaces of Vitoria-Gasteiz, the autonomous community's capital. We rode bicycles on Vitoria-Gasteiz's separate lanes past a street that was once a 6-lane highway devoid of business activity. Today it's a shared space, complete with a streetcar line, a walkable promenade, and many locally owned people-centric stores catering to pedestrians. So few of North Carolina's politicians are willing to question the primacy of the car in a state that once held building a 4-lane highway accessible to every citizen as a tool for lowering income inequality. More than any North Carolina city, Charlotte has committed to a smarter urbanism more inclusive of transit-oriented development. It is time that cities and even smaller towns begin discussing the advantages of density. Looking at you, Chapel Hill, including energy efficiency, community development, and decreasing infrastructure costs. At many points in my trip, I took a moment to assess how I felt about the things that I was learning. It was truly impressive how quickly Germany was able to increase its share of renewable energies, or how easy it was to travel around Vitoria-Gasteiz with only a bicycle. Above all, I felt envy. Envious of how these communities were able to transition to a renewed future with renewables. Envious of politicians willing to say no to business as usual, polluting utilities, and car-centric development. I returned to North Carolina invigorated, willing to turn that envy into action any way I can. So let's have our own energy revolution here in North Carolina.